focus story. With the passing away of Jayalalithaa, the AIADMK has lost a leader who had become virtually synonymous with the party. Now, reports say the party is divided into two groups led by Sasikala Natarajan and CMO Panneerselvam, respectively. Sources say M. Thambidurai may emerge as the consensus candidate. Which way is the AIADMK heading is the big question. Meanwhile, CMO Panneerselvam is holding his first cabinet meet at the state secretariat after being sworn in. The meeting will begin at 11:30 a.m. Panneerselvam is expected to adopt a resolution to accord formal sanction for a suitably impressive memorial for
Jayalalithaa. और उसको पनीर ही मैं बुलाता हूं Panneerselvam नहीं कहता हूं और Sasikala उसको हटाने पसंद करेगी क्योंकि जो वो काम उनसे करा कराने के लिए चाहेगी वो भी वो कर नहीं पाएगा तो इसीलिए किसी और अपना कोई आदमी को लाने के प्रयास करिए उसी समय पार्टी का
वी आर गोइंग टू हैव अ जनरल बॉडी मीटिंग वेरी सून ओनली इन जनरल बॉडी मीटिंग विल डिसाइड हु इज गोइंग टू टेक द पार्ट सो नाउ ऑल दिस रूमर्स वी डोंट आंसर In the general body meeting, we'll
tell. Deputy Editor Priyamada joins us with further details. Priyamada, Panneerselvam, the newly appointed Chief Minister of Tamil Nadu, all set to hold his first cabinet meet today in the post-Amma era.
Absolutely. This is the first cabinet meeting that O. Panneerselvam and his ministers are holding post-Amma era. Definitely a resolution. First, there will be a condolence meeting kind. And after that, a resolution will be passed, probably something to do with Amma Memorial. That is something that is expected out of this cabinet meeting because the government has to be up and running. They have to address various issues, including that of Kaveri issue and the Jallikattu issue because in the month of January, there will be a big demand from people in South Tamil Nadu to conduct Jallikattu and the government has to make a decision about it. So now there is going to be a cabinet meeting conducted at 11:30 by O. Panneerselvam. Meanwhile, around 11 o'clock, AIADMK spokesperson has called for an urgent press meet to quell the rumors about spreading about.
புரட்சித் தலைவி அம்மா அவர்களின் அடிச்சு வட்டி மாபெரும் அனைத்திந்திய அதிமுக எனும் புனித இயக்கத்தை மாண்புமிகு அம்மா அவர்களின் அடிச்சு வட்டேன் மாண்புமிகு அம்மா அவர்களின் மீது தெய்வப்பற்று மிக்க கழக தொண்டர்களையும் அனைத்து தரப்பு மக்களையும் காத்திடும் வகையில் பொதுச் செயலாளர் ஒருவரை கழகம் விரைவில் தேர்ந்தெடுக்கும் அனைத்திந்திய அதிமுக அளப்பரிய ஒற்றுமை நிறைந்த ஒரு கொள்கை கோட்டை இதில் இவர்தான் பொதுச் செயலாளர் அவர்தான் பொதுச் செயலாளர் என்ற ஒரு நிலையே உருவாகவில்லை வதந்திகள் மட்டுமே பரப்பப்படுகின்றன இதை தெளிவுபடுத்துகிறேன் நன்றி வணக்கம் விரைவில் பொதுச் செயலாளர் ஒருவரை நான் ஏற்கனவே கூறியதைப் போல தொண்டர்களையும் இந்த மாபெரும் இயக்கத்தையும் தமிழக மக்கள் அனைத்து தரப்பினரையும் காக்கும் வகையில் விரைவிலே தேர்ந்தெடுக்க தலைமை முடிவு செய்யும் தலைமை முடிவு செய்திருக்கிறது விரைவிலே தேர்ந்தெடுக்கப்படுவார்
சார் அதுக்கு நிறைய போட்டி இருக்கிறதுனாலதான் ஒரு முடிவுக்கு வர முடியாது
அதைத்தான் நான் தெளிவுபடுத்துகிறேன் அப்படி போட்டி என்பதும் வதந்தி ஒற்றுமை நிறைந்த கட்சி
Right, Priyamada is still with us. Priyamada, that was an AIADMK press conference, we believe, coming in.
Ponnaiyin has just given a clarification about the rumors that is coming in because for the last couple of days we are seeing rumors about infighting within the AIADMK and also whether Sasikala will be given the mantle of the general secretary of the AIADMK. So Ponnaiyin has now come out and given a clarification saying that AIADMK is a democratic party and it will function as per the rules books of the AIADMK where it will take a decision very soon at the general council meeting about who will be the general secretary of the party and has requested people not to believe in any kind of rumor or any kind of problem within the AIADMK. He has gone on to say that everything is fine and there is no necessity to believe in the rumor. So that's like a damage control operation that the AIADMK is doing considering there are so questions and also uncertainty about the situation inside the ADMK.
Absolutely, and this is the very environment, Priyamvada, within which Panneerselvam will hold his meeting. We believe one of the other decisions in this cabinet meet is likely to be on a memorial for Jayalalithaa. Is that correct? Could that be discussed
well,
as
that's
well?
That's what our sources are telling us. That's what our sources are telling us, that there will be something about Jayalalithaa's memorial. She's already been laid to rest next to the memorial of MGR. So she might see something about, the cabinet might decide about the construction of a memorial for Jayalalithaa in a very grand manner in Marina Beach. So that's going to be definitely one of the resolutions that's likely to be passed at the cabinet meeting today.
Right, and of course, Panneerselvam chairing this meet at a time when, you know, there are these various rumors, of course, about who's going to really take charge of the party in the post-Amma era. Of course, the AIADMK trying to, quash those rumors in that press conference, Priyamvada, as you were just telling us. But still, there are a lot of rumors about these factions which seem to have emerged within the party.
It's not just the rumors. But also our sources are telling us like how there are different power centers that have emerged. One, of course, we know Sasikala, but then the main problem now, some of the party members are not happy with the interference of Sasikala's family members who are trying to emerge as smaller power centers. And then there is O Panneerselvam, and then there is Edappadi Palaniswami. So there are different groups which are emerging. Of course, Sengotayan was seen as another faction, but yesterday he had issued a press statement saying that he will give his support to Sasikala and he is giving solidarity to Sasikala. So that's like in a way, Sasikala managed to bring Sengotayan faction under her control. So we have to wait and see if Sasikala is in a position to consolidate the remaining factions in the group, put everyone together under the same roof and function, because it's going to be very crucial. They've got 4.5 years of power and ADMK cannot afford to appear as a very vulnerable party with a lot of insights, because the opposition parties or a national party could take advantage of the situation, which the ADMK cannot afford considering they have power for 4.5 years.
Absolutely. And Priyamvada, could M. Thambidurai then emerge as a consensus candidate? Could he be elevated within the party? That's another big question emerging.
Well, that, in fact, sources say that's what the BJP had advised Sasikala. But obviously, Sasikala wants to become the general secretary. Her members are pitching for her to be made as general secretary, because 80% of the important general council meeting, general body members have been handpicked by Sasikala. So they are all Sasikala loyalists. So we have to wait and see whether it's going to be given away to Thambidurai or Sasikala is going to hold that position and allow O Panneerselvam to function as the chief minister. Something like what we witnessed in the center, how Sonia Gandhi was holding the party but allowed Manmohan Singh to function as the chief minister. So we have to wait and see if Sasikala is going to do something like that, because it's very crucial that a consensus is arrived and everyone is brought in the control. Thambidurai is definitely one of the
yes.
options names that are doing rounds, but still no confirmation.
Absolutely. We'll have to leave it there, Priyamvada. Thank you for joining us with